Welcome to the U.S. Food and Drug Administration's presentation series on complex innovative trial designs, often referred to as CIDs. In this session, I'll introduce you to some of FDA's efforts to advance the use of CIDs. The landscape of drug development is changing, as evidenced by increased attention in areas such as real-world evidence, patient-focused drug development, and innovative clinical trial designs such as master protocols. As drug development evolves, we are facing unique challenges and opportunities. Some of FDA's approaches to meeting these challenges are included in the seventh iteration of the Prescription Drug User Fee Amendments for fiscal years 2023 to 2027, commonly referred to as PDUFA 7. This presentation focuses on one aspect of PDUFA 7, complex innovative trial designs. The goal of FDA's CID efforts is to facilitate the advancement and use of complex adaptive, Bayesian, and other novel clinical trial designs, including those requiring simulations to determine statistical properties. To advance the use of CIDs, FDA will continue to develop staff capacity, engage external experts, maintain the paired meeting program, convene a public workshop, and publish a draft guidance on the use of Bayesian methodology in clinical trials of drugs and biologics. The statistical units within FDA's Center for Drug Evaluation and Research, CDER, and the Center for Biologics Evaluation and Research, CBER, are the leads for CID efforts. Staff from other relevant disciplines are active participants. Why do we need CIDs? In many cases, there are straightforward and well-known approaches to designing and analyzing studies of medical products. But in other scenarios, the path is not so clear. Innovative thinking and methodology can help establish optimal study designs and may even provide a solution for challenging clinical drug development problems. That's where CIDs come in. There are many ways in which CIDs can be used in drug development. For instance, drug development for rare diseases is challenging because of small patient populations for clinical trials. Certain types of CIDs could allow drug developers to leverage other data sources, such as early clinical studies or natural history data, to gain additional power to detect differences in therapeutic options. In the anti-infective space, data could be leveraged across multiple body sites when trying to establish the effect of a treatment for a rare pathogen. CIDs also might be used to assess multiple interventions, diseases, or subgroups under a master protocol, defined as a single overarching protocol designed to answer multiple questions. One example of a master protocol is the Partnership for Research on Ebola Virus and Liberia 2, also known as PREVAIL 2. I will discuss PREVAIL 2 in more detail in subsequent slides. Another example is LungMap, which can be thought of as a collection of separate sub-studies corresponding to genetic subgroups, conducted under a single master protocol designed to generate evidence of safety and effectiveness for biomarker-matched therapies. Leveraging data and using master protocols are just two examples of how CIDs might benefit drug development. The possibilities are endless. What are some possible features of CIDs? CIDs may include any several features or a combination of features, including, but not limited to, use of external controls, incorporation of adaptations to multiple design features, formal incorporation of prior knowledge, use of posterior probability, novel application of complex design features, master protocols, and sequential multiple assignment randomized trial designs. These features allow one to envision several different ways CIDs could be used in drug development. Think back to the Ebola outbreak that began in 2014 as an example of a drug development challenge where a complex design could prove beneficial. As we all recall, there was an urgent need to identify safe and effective therapies. Supplies of several potential therapeutic agents were limited or intermittent. We needed to maximize information from limited data. Given the situation, there was agreement that a flexible design and analysis approach were needed. Borrowing a quote from a paper by Drs. Woodcock and Lavange, we needed to answer more questions more efficiently and in less time. Designed as a master protocol for Ebola therapies, the PREVAIL 2 study included a shared control arm and provided the ability to evaluate multiple Ebola therapies simultaneously. Treatments could be added or dropped. The novel adaptive design applied Bayesian decision rules for concluding effectiveness at interim or final analysis. Although the Ebola outbreak waned before the study was fully enrolled, the results showed a trend towards increased survival among patients who had received the experimental treatment. Now that we've explored the why behind CIDs, let's move to the what. As previously mentioned, FDA has been and will continue to conduct activities to advance the use of complex, innovative trial designs, including continuing the paired meeting program and convening a public workshop. The public workshop will discuss aspects of complex adaptive, Bayesian, and other novel clinical trial designs. Topics will include considerations for external data sources, Bayesian statistical methods, simulations, and clinical trial implementation. Discussion topics will be based on FDA accumulated experience both within and outside of the paired meeting program. On October 20th, 2022, FDA announced the paired meeting program will be maintained in the Federal Register. The paired meeting program is designed for highly innovative trials for which analytically derived properties may not be feasible and simulations are needed to determine statistical properties. Interested sponsors should submit meeting requests to propose CIDs. For details on the submission process, please refer to the CID process presentation on this website. FDA selects up to 2 meeting requests for the program per quarter. For granted meeting requests, FDA will conduct an initial and follow-up meeting to discuss regulatory approaches on the same proposed CID and medical product. Within 45 days after the quarterly closing date, FDA will review and select meeting requests to proceed to disclosure discussions and notify sponsors of their status. The follow-up meeting will occur approximately 90 days of receiving the briefing materials. FDA may present trial designs as case studies for continuing education and information sharing, contingent on FDA and the sponsor reaching a disclosure agreement. We have now concluded our brief overview of the FDA's CID efforts. These efforts will advance the use of CIDs, increase opportunities for collaboration among a variety of stakeholders, and support innovative medical product development. But the most important aspect may be the benefit to patients, because the overall goal of FDA's CID efforts is to promote the development of innovative designs and analysis that may advance new therapies across a diverse range of areas of need. Thank you for your interest in the FDA's CID efforts. We hope that you also view FDA's companion presentation on the CID paired meeting program process. For more information, please visit the CID website or submit questions via email to cid.meetings@fda.hhs.gov.